Egon Balas is a giant of operations research, and you know, he was really a pioneer in integer programming, like 20 years ahead of anybody else.
When I was 17, I started in high school to study physics, and I came across relativity. And I was so much caught by the excitement of this new, entirely new theory of the world. You know, there is the saying, facts are stubborn things. Here is a small fact, and this small fact was sufficiently powerful to cause a revolution in our whole view of the world. Had the war not come into my part of the world, I would have become a physicist in all likelihood. The Nazis were conquering the world and were doing terrible things. I didn't like to be simply a spectator. I wanted to be a participant, so I wanted to fight the Nazis. I met my current wife, Edith, in 46. I married her in 48.
He's 7 years older than me, and he went through so much in his life. He was always very focused in his work. So first work, and then work, and second work, and then maybe the family and the rest of the world.
My first project was joint with Peter Hammer, and we worked out an optimal transportation plan for the firewood all across the country, which required the solution of a linear programming problem. In 1963, I had to solve a forestry problem. There was a plot of forests which needed a harvesting plan for the next 5-year period. And I formulated that as an integer programming problem, 0, 1 variables, yes or no variables, bivalent, we call them, two-value variables. I devised my own procedure and solved the problem and presented the article first in Bucharest and then sent it to the West. And that was a big hit, a big success. It's called the additive algorithm. Ultimately, it was published 2 years later in Operations Research, and for 32 years, it was the most cited article. That was my step into the profession.
Some people say that algorithms are now a trillion times faster than they were 30 years ago. Part of it is due to faster computers, but the bulk of it is due to better algorithms. And this was pioneered by Egon Balas in the 70s.
Integer programming stayed that way. A rich theory was built, but it still couldn't solve problems beyond a small number of variables for 30, 40 years. And the situation changed in this period between 1990 and 2005, this revolution occurred in the state of the art, and our work, Gerard's and mine and some others, played a crucial role in this revolution in the state of the art. So now, integer programs can be solved, not all of them. There are still cases which are unsolvable in practical time. But the run-of-the-mill problem that you come across in practical life nowadays can be solved. This was the revolution in the state of the art of the integer programming field.
We talk a lot, we are very good friends. I know it's always a pleasure to bounce off ideas.
How long is the flight?
on Wednesday evenings. We play tennis. We've been doing this at least 20 years, probably more. He's done so much for me. I'm just so grateful that I have such a friend. He has this very independent way of thinking, very unique way of thinking. So, I know that makes him a great researcher because I know he doesn't think like others would.
Do you have an example in mind?
Yes, so this is an example.
Working with Dr. Balas it's an honor and a privilege. He's really, really good at forming the story that is told. Given the same kind of data, you can tell different types of stories. And he's very good at seeing the bigger picture. He wants to make a real practical impact, meaning that he won't work on theoretical questions if there are no practical impacts that can be made from that in the future that he sees.
His gift is intellectual capability, concentration, discipline. What he has to do, he would do that. So he is very focused. He is not interested in what is happening. He didn't know about Lady Gaga until last year, or anybody. He is very, very focused in his work, which is good, because this is how people achieve something.
Having Dr. Balas on the Tepper faculty, I think, has and will continue to influence the path that Tepper takes for generations to come.
Most people do a job which after a while becomes boring, and work becomes a burden. And so retirement is a very wise institution and necessary. But some people who are very lucky, I consider myself among those, have a job which they enjoy doing. I do what I like most. I do research. I teach the subjects that I'm interested in. I enjoy getting other people know the facts and getting interested in, so why would I quit?